Hello, I'm Kurt David, former professional athlete and author of the book From Glory Days. And this is the From Glory Days show, which chronicles the lives of professional athletes following their pro sports careers. Watch the stories unfold as Hall of Fame, All-Star, and World Champion professional athletes share their personal stories of struggle and success as they've transitioned from the pinnacle of their pro sports careers back into normal, everyday lives. You won't find another show like this one that captures this transition as told directly by the athletes themselves. Hello, I'm Kurt David, author of the best-selling book From Glory Days, and your host of the From Glory Days show. Our guest today was a three-sport All-State athlete at Flint Southwestern High School. After a stellar high school career, he went on to become a two-sport All-American at the University of Michigan in both football and baseball. Following his record-breaking college career, our guest was drafted by the NFL's Denver Broncos and a first-round pick by the Detroit Tigers. Opting for baseball over football, he played 10 seasons of Major League Baseball with four different clubs. In 1999, he was listed by Sports Illustrated as one of the 50 greatest sports figures from Michigan. And in 2008, he was inducted into the State of Michigan Sports Hall of Fame. Let's give a nice warm welcome to our guest, Rick Leach. Thanks for coming on the show today, Rick.
Thanks, Kurt. Good to be here.
I got to tell you, Rick, in my mind, you are like an athletic thoroughbred, you know, from high school through college through the pros, just like a thoroughbred. And one of the thoughts I had is, do you have any idea how many games you played throughout your career at all, from high school, college, professionally?
No, I would have no idea. Certainly, it's a large number. And then, of course, playing three sports, and then you go in summer programs and playing games there, I'm sure is quite a large number.
Well, I did a rough estimate, so let's see how close we are. Between high school playing three sports, from college playing two sports, All-American in both sports, playing 10 seasons of Major League Baseball, plus some additional minor league I threw in there as well. I have an approximate 1,546 games. Does that sound about right to you?
Does that include all the games with my boys in the backyard?
Definitely not. I think we'll have to double it for that then, if that's the case. But seriously, though, let's talk about your athletic career. Let's talk about some of the highlights of your career. Where would you like to start? What were some of the highlights? When you look back on your career, early, from high school, college, professionally, what were some of the highlights in your mind?
There was a lot of highlights, obviously, but as far back as I can remember, I just love playing athletics. I grew up in an athletic family. My dad played at the University of Michigan on a national championship baseball team, was drafted in the Tigers farm system. Back then, he couldn't start right away because he got drafted in the armed services and had to go in the military for a few years. And when he got out, he had to try and determine whether he wanted to keep playing. But he had already started a family, so he decided to go into teaching and coaching. So I was very fortunate. Some of the people that maybe have some background knowledge in the state of Michigan, he was always known as an outstanding coach that had a lot of great teams, both in football and baseball. And so as long as I can remember, even when I was a youngster, I was always, you know, I was around the practices, trying to fool around with the older guys.
Strong influence from your father, from coaching and being involved. So you were involved early with sports and everything, and from a wee kid all the way on up. What were some of the highlights of your own career as an athlete?
Well, I think one of the highlights was I was played three sports, as you said, and I think it's accurate that I was the first player in the state of Michigan to be All-State in three different sports, football, basketball, and baseball. We had some wonderful teams and played in a great league, the Saginaw Valley, which was extremely strong in all sports. So there was tremendous amount of competition, a lot of great players, and I think that helped propel me because of the coaches I had in the league I played in, that I could go to the University of Michigan and accomplish the things that happened there.
At that point. Now, you narrowed it down, too. You had three sports that you were All-State athlete at from Flint Southwestern. Got it narrowed down to two sports at that point. Help us understand about that decision. First of all, one, why those two sports? And two, why University of Michigan?
Well, I always grew up, as I said, from my dad playing there. I always had a Michigan background. And grew up following them and going to some of the games. The way that it turned out for me, it was kind of unique in some ways. because I knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that I was told and was scouted heavily in baseball because you can be drafted out of high school. Mm-hmm. So I had a lot of people following me and knew that I was going to have an opportunity there because of my size. I didn't know, of course, basketball. I wasn't 6 foot six plus or whatever. And in football, you know, I thought that I may have a chance there, but I felt I had to get in the right offense mm-hmm. or play in a team. Now, as you know, Kurt, because we've been friends for a pretty good while, I came out of a high school system where I threw probably 25, sometimes 30 times a game mm-hmm. and didn't run a lick except when I scrambled. And that kind of, that tide had turned when I went to Michigan. Of course, when I was recruited, I was told they were going to open it up a lot more than they eventually did.
That was a little different, yeah, once you got there.
But the main thing was, once Bo had never allowed an athlete at that point to play more than one sport. If you came on a football scholarship, that was it. You were 100% football. Mm-hmm. And that was one of the things early in the recruiting process, I let them know that, because I knew I had a future in baseball and
in
didn't
fact,
want to jeopardize
not
that.
Not to interrupt, but coming out of high school, you had a chance for baseball right off the bat, didn't you, to play professionally? Tell us about, can you tell us about that? What was that?
Well, I was scouted, and then there was a real well-known scout. In fact, he was one of the most well-known scouts in baseball. He was with the Philadelphia Phillies organization, mm-hmm. a guy named Tony Lucadello. And he had always taken a shine to me and liked what he saw. So even after I had signed my tender to go to the University of Michigan, the baseball draft was later in that spring. Mm-hmm. And they wanted to still go ahead and draft me, but only with guarantees that I would come there to play. So they had the ability, because they were going to draft in the first round, that they could discuss some parameters on the financial side. And they had my dad and I in a hotel up in Flint talking about it. And to be honest, it's a long story, but he wrote a number on a piece of paper and said he was going to leave the room. He wanted my dad and I to look at it, and then he was going to come back
in. And that was the offer number.
That was the offer number.
Or was that the signing bonus? That was the offer.
That was the signing bonus.
Okay, that was
right, which is all they could talk about. Mm-hmm. And when he walked out of the room, of course, I flipped it over real quick, and I looked at my dad, and I said, that's me right there.
Your dad had different ideas.
He had a different idea. So Tony came back in the room, and he said, you're going to need to stay out there. I need to talk with my son for a little bit.
Well, it's not too bad of a story after that, though. You did decide to go to Michigan, played both football and baseball. You were able to work that out with Bo, obviously. You had to do some talking at first, but you played baseball and football as a result.
Right.
What were some of the highlights from that career as far as football and baseball at Michigan?
Well, I would say on the football side, of course, going down and be able to start right out of the gate in my first game as a freshman. I was kind of in a good situation because Dennis Franklin had started there mm-hmm. 3 years previous. So maybe some of the top echelon quarterbacks that they tried to recruit for whatever reason, they didn't come there. So I had a good opportunity when I went down there. And then from the first scrimmage that we had, a guy named Mark Elzinga that was from Bay City and was there, he was a senior. He got knocked out on the first play of the first scrimmage that I ever participated in. So I got a break right away, got an opportunity to do some things. It worked out. So, but when I look back, probably the main highlights, of course, everybody's pretty familiar at the time Woody Hayes was coaching at Ohio State. During that period is what they've even written books about. They call it the 10-year war, and I participated in four of them. We got beat on a last-second touchdown my freshman year and then won three in a row, and two of those were down in Columbus. So,
and you got a great story, too. We talk about those Ohio State days, but I think there was a great story you had with somebody over at Notre Dame at that time, too, during your football career, and I know that's a great story. I think our listeners would love to hear that, too, the brief story that you told about you and going into that big game down in South Bend, Indiana?
Well, when we played Notre Dame, which took place during my senior year, that was the first time that they had played each other in, I think, like 34, 35 years. There was animosity from past regimes and athletic directors. So that was the first game that they were going to play. Mm-hmm. And we were looking forward to, in fact, that was one of the things I used when I was being recruited. But I was very good friends with Bob Ufer, who most people that follow Michigan are aware of. We were very close. He had talked about this for 4 years, and real quick, a guy rolled my ankle on Monday. We were just in sweats working out, and a guy got bumped off balance and
Monday
rolled right
of the
up.
Week of the game,
the week of the